Welcome to Bible Vision Ministries Bible Class, Saturday morning Bible Class. I'm Pastor Velvelette Poole, and I'm so excited today. We're going to be talking about looking unto Jesus. So come on and join us. Come on and pop on Facebook, and this one will be on my website. Yes, we are. We're in the hands of God. Amen. Yes, we're standing together. Come what may. In the hands of our Savior, we're going to remain in the hands of Jesus. Hallelujah. The power that strengthens us, it will never die. Yes. Standing together, come what may. Until we're home, until we're in heaven. Hallelujah. Yeah, standing together. Hallelujah, come on, May. Yes, we're going to remain in Jesus. Yes, hallelujah. We're going to remain in Jesus. Hallelujah. How about you? Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Our Bob Carlisle, thank God for him and then making that song. Praise God. I used to play that song on WPJL years ago, when I had my broadcast on radio. Amen. I don't know if you guys remember that song or not, but praise God. It just reminds us that we're in the hands of Jesus, no matter what we're going through today. Truly, these are perilous times. And we've been on Facebook Live having church, oh my God, for, you know, just about every Saturday. And so I'm thanking God that God is just confirming, you know, his word. And, you know, thank God that Bible Vision Ministries can continue to come to you until they shut Facebook down, until they stop social media from happening. We're going to be here. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. My name is Pastor Velvelette Poole, and I'm glad to be with you today. We're going to be coming from Hebrews 12. We're going to have a little Bible study, praise God, online. And I think it's always pertinent on the Sabbath to give God the glory and give God the praise, because he is worthy of all praise and honor this morning. Praise God. But first, we're going to have prayer, and I'm going to be coming to you from Hebrews chapter 12. So while we're yet praying, you can get your Bibles ready for Hebrews chapter 12. We're going to talk about looking unto Jesus. That's what we need to be doing in a time like this, is looking to him who's the author and finisher of our faith. Heavenly Father, we come to you in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you this morning. We give you praise. We give you honor. We give you glory this morning. We thank you, God, for just being in the midst of the saints of God online, praise God. By my website, however you're viewing this video today, we're truly thankful, God, for our viewers. And we thank you, God, for just being God. You are the God of heaven and earth. There is no other. And we thank you today. And we praise you, God, for having life, health, and strength, for being well, for being healed in our bodies. We thank you, Lord, today. We thank you for how you walked along this road with us every step of the way. You have not led us astray, no kind of way. And we are thankful this morning. We give you praise. We give you honor, oh God, for just walking in your will this morning. Praise God. Hallelujah. And we thank you, God. We repent this morning in the mighty name of Jesus for everything that we might have done to, you know, to offend anyone. We repent this morning, God. We're asking you that, God, bless this ministry. We ask you to bless the people in under the sound of my voice. Heal their bodies if they're sick. Oh, God, just help us in a time like this to continue to bless us financially, bless us spiritually. God, we just thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And bless the reading of your word today as well, God. We thank you, God. Amen. For the reading of your word. Amen. Praise God. So we're going to come from Hebrews chapter 12, and I am going to read Hebrews chapter 12 this morning to you. And like I said, I was hoping my husband would join me this morning. I got him up and said, come on, let's do this. And he laid back down. So I said, Lord, I thank you. I'm going to keep on doing this because you told me this is my calling. God gave this to me. I created, you know, God gave this to me and told me to go forth into Bible Vision Ministries. Before I even married him, I was doing this on the radio. And so I thank God that God has given this ministry to me, and this is what God has called me to do. Amen. It says, wherefore, seeing we also are compassed with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth so easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, who is the author and the finisher of our faith, for who the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God. Amen. For consider him that endured such contradiction of sinners against himself, lest ye be wearied and faint in your minds. Ye have not yet resisted unto blood, striving against sin. So you ain't seen nothing yet. Amen. We ain't seen nothing yet. This is just the beginning of sorrows, as I was talking about in Matthew chapter 24 as last Saturday. And I'm sorry, I got cut off last Saturday as you were listening to me. I was having some difficulties. But I want you to know this morning that this is just the beginning of sorrows. We haven't strived against blood. You know, we haven't resisted unto blood, striving against sin. We ain't started bleeding yet, y'all. We might be going without, you know, some things we might need. Amen. But we have not gotten to the point where we're bleeding for Christ. Amen. Trying to get to the Lord. And I'm looking for Jesus to come back. I'm so excited about it. I don't know what to do. These are the last days. If you don't believe it, look, just take a look at the TV programs you have to listen to on the news media. Look and see. We need to be looking to Jesus. Don't look at your TV too much. You need to have your eyes shown up for the skies, because eventually Jesus is going to come back again. And I'm so excited about it in my soul. Amen. I know he's coming. Praise God. And I want to be ready. What about you? Praise God. I want to be ready. I'm looking to Jesus this morning, the author and the finisher of our faith. Amen. And it says, consider, and he endured such contradiction of sinners. In other words, he endured the cross, despising the shame. You know, and when we think about how Jesus died and shed blood on the cross for us, I have to go back to how he died and he rose again in the resurrection. He rose again. He was on the cross with two thieves on his left side and on his right. Praise God. But he didn't deserve to be on the cross. But because he laid his life down for me and for you, praise God, I'm so excited about today. Jesus, he's the reason. He's the reason for everything. Reason for the season, Easter. And I don't like to call it Easter because that's a pagan term, but we call it the Passover where I come from. Praise God, the Passover. Amen. But this is telling us something to do here. Right before Jesus comes, it's saying, seeing we all compassed with so great a cloud of witnesses. What witnesses are we talking about? Jesus was a witness. His disciples were a witness. And the people that came before us are witnesses. Some of us, our mothers and fathers, were witnesses. I got a mother right now that's a witness. Amen. But she's still alive on the earth. But we're talking about the ones that have gone on. Praise God. There are a lot of preachers that have gone on. There are a lot of ministers and people and saints of God that have gone on and shown us the way. And they're cheering us on, you know, in heaven right now, looking down upon us and saying, come on, you can do this. Lay aside every weight, everything that might be holding you back this morning. Hallelujah. God has moved some things out of the way. Some of you are working from home. God has moved some stuff out of the way for you so you can seek his face. Amen. This is a time like none other to seek the face of God, looking to Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, knowing this, that Jesus died and what he had to go through. And so the suffering of our present time is nothing compared to what Jesus went through. But we're going to go through some things. So praise God, on today, I'm going to go back to Matthew chapter 24. We were talking last week about the end times. And I still want to talk a little bit on the end times, because that's what we're in, the end times. And I want to shed some light on what Jesus said about the end times. And so we're going to go back to Matthew chapter 24. I'm not going to let the enemy shut me up. One preacher I was listening to, he said, you know, they tried to shut me off on social media. I can't even get my stuff up. I said, you're not alone, brother. They don't like this, but we're going to preach this thing. He that endureth the end, the same shall be saved. We're going to preach this thing until there's nobody left to hear it. Amen. Until God take us to glory. Hallelujah. We're going to preach the word of God. We're going to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ until there's nobody left. Until Jesus comes and takes us all up in the rapture, we're going to be preaching this thing. Amen. It ain't going to stop. It ain't going to never stop. Amen. Praise God. And I thank God for that. Amen. If I'm the only one, I'm here waving my hand, saying Jesus is Lord, I'm going to preach it everywhere I go. I'm going to say it to whoever I want to say it to, whatever that God tell me to say, because why? He called me. No man didn't call me. God called me into the ministry. He told me to go preach it everywhere I go and everything that I do. Praise God. Show myself worthy of preaching the gospel. And so I have. I've lived a life. So let's go on to Matthew chapter 24. If you got it there. And we're going to begin at first verse. And Jesus went out and departed from the temple. And his disciples came unto him to show him the building of the temple. And Jesus said, see ye not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down. And he sat upon the Mount of Olives. As he sat on the Mount of Olives, the disciples came to him privately saying, tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and the end of the world? And so as Jesus answered and said unto them, take heed, no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name saying, I am the Christ, and shall deceive many. Oh, that's happening everywhere you go now. Somebody's saying, I'm of Christ and I am the Christ. And, you know, there are a lot of people trying to act like they're Christ. But I'm here to tell you there's only one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Amen. Praise God. Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Nobody but Jesus. When you go to look to see, if you're staying, when you get ready to stand before the Lord, ain't going to be nobody sitting up there on the throne but Jesus. Jesus and him crucified, the Lamb of God that shed blood for many. There's nobody else up there that's going to be sitting on the throne but Jesus Christ. Amen. Every knee shall bow. Every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Amen. Okay. And then it says, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars, and see that you be not troubled. For these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. Amen. So we know that the end is not yet. Even now, even though things are beginning to change, you can look around and, you know, and realize that because of the curfew, we've got curfews all over the land, and we got where we can't do so much. We can't even buy but one thing in the grocery store. They're limiting us. They're rationing our food. Everything's going on. And this is just the beginning of sorrows, as the word of God quickly says here. And ye shall hear wars and rumors of wars. See that you be not troubled. God wants you to know today, you don't have to be worried about a thing if you're living for him. You ain't got to be worried about nothing if you're living for the Lord. You don't have to worry about anything. You don't have to get depressed and cry and be upset and wonder what's getting ready to happen. Because why? You belong to the King. You belong to Jesus. He's the one that's taken us to this very point. We have been chosen, us that are sanctified. We've been chosen to live in a time like this. We've been chosen. We are the last days. You know, the word of God says in Joel, he said in Joel chapter 2, verse 28, praise God. And I can't hardly get it out today because I'm so excited. Amen. In my soul. Amen. It talks about, and men will be, praise God, let me get it because the enemy has just taken it from me. Even though I quoted the scripture of Joel chapter 28, praise God. And Joel chapter 2, verse 28, he's just like he took it from me. Amen. Praise God. But I want you to know today that I'm just too excited in my soul. I'm excited because Jesus is Lord. I'm excited because I'm serving the Lord, and he is, you know, worthy of all praise and honor and glory. Amen. Praise God. So Joel chapter 2, verse 28, and it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams. Your young men shall see visions. Amen. And also upon my servants and upon my handmaids, in those days will I pour out my spirit. So these are the last days. This is when Jesus, when God is doing a great work, where we're going to see more and more people getting saved because we're living in the last days. And they can see the hand of God moving. They can see that it's not like it used to be. Praise God. We can see the signs in the earth. We can see they were talking about last year about an android coming almost close enough to the earth to hit the earth and destroy it, but it didn't happen. So I thank God, because, you know, these are the last days. There'll be signs and it says in verse 30, I will show signs in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. So it's happening. It's happening, you know. So what we've got to do is just make sure that we're ready to meet God. We got to repent. We got to repent, and we got to ask God to help us, praise God, in a time like this. Amen. And just remember, we're in the hands of Jesus. Just remember, we're in the hands of Jesus. There is no other name that we can call on, that every everything in the earth is subject to is the name of Jesus Christ. I thank God for the scripture that it says that the, it seems like the more I talk about this thing, it's like my words just don't come. Amen. But the word of God says the name of Jesus is a strong tower and the righteous run in and are safe. Amen. And so we don't have to worry about being protected this morning, according to Psalms 91. Amen. Praise God. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Praise God. So we don't have to worry about it. We're in the secret place. Amen. We are protected under the hand of Jesus. Praise God. Under the hands of the Lord. Amen. Let me keep going, because let me just talk about the wars and rumors of wars. Now, there's chemical warfare going on. Somebody didn't hear me. Chemical warfare. And then there's rumors of chemical warfare. So there's all kinds of things going on in the earth. People are lying about it being a war. Some people are lying about it being pestilences. Some people are lying about it being sickness and disease. It's just a lot going on in the world. But it says, for nation shall rise up against nation and kingdom against kingdom. Praise God. And there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in divers places. And all these, verse 8, are the beginning of sorrow. So the end is not yet. But the end is not yet. Praise God. See that you be not troubled. See that you be at peace among yourselves. Praise God. You're at home. Praise God with each other now. We can't get so close to people anymore. Praise God. So this just confirms that the Lord had told me to go do an online ministry. But I kept questioning it in my spirit. I said, Lord, are you sure? Are you sure you want me to do an online ministry? And God said, yes, I want you to go forth and do an online ministry. But I didn't understand it at the time. And you know, that's the way it is sometimes. When God tells you to do something way ahead of time, you kind of question it. And you'd be like, okay, God, is there anybody listening to me? Is there anybody that's going to pay attention to this online ministry? But now that people can't get to the church house, or now that people are, you know, they can't get in groups of more than 50. And if they do go to the church house, they can't touch each other, you know, or, you know, it's against the law to cough. I heard one man that he got arrested for coughing. In public. I mean, come on now. I mean, this is just getting ridiculous. Amen. Coughing in public. No, I guess they figure he had the virus or whatever. But today, what we want to know and what we want to realize is that Jesus is a healer. He's a healer. And so, no, you ask me, am I afraid that no, I'm not. I belong to God. You belong to God. So why should you be afraid? Why should you be fearful? See that you be not troubled this morning. See that you be not troubled. Because all this is to begin. This is supposed to happen. All this shutting down of the school. All this was supposed to happen. This is not anything unnormal. And I told you something was coming, didn't I tell you? Something was coming. I told you something was coming. But nevertheless, it's all about knowing Jesus and looking to him. It's looking to Jesus, the author, the finisher of our faith. Not to each other. Not to the preacher, but to Jesus. Don't look to me. I'm just a woman. I'm just a woman of God. Look to Jesus, who's the author of our finisher and our faith, because he's the only one that's going to get us through everything that is coming up in the last days. Amen. So praise God. Yes, there are going to be lies going on, and there's still lies. Don't believe what you're hearing all the time. Don't. That's why don't be so quick to hear the, you know, turn the TV up for the news. I mean, I'm not saying that you shouldn't listen to the news, and I listen to it sometimes to try to figure out what they're saying, but let's concentrate on our faith, the faith that was once delivered to the saints. Let's get back in the Bible. You ever thought the reason that you're at home now is because God wants you to get closer to him? There's a reason this is happening. All these things are happening. And some people say, I've been home for a while. Some people say, well, I've been home. Well, what have you been seeking the face of God while you're home? I know the kids are at home, and that's kind of could be a distraction, but see if you can get some time with God. I mean, some one-on-one time with him. Amen. And what you do, and start praying that the Lord will deliver the nations, because it says nations shall rise up against nations and kingdom against kingdom. And there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in divers places. Well, that's already happening. That's been happening for a while. It says, and then they shall deliver you up to be afflicted. Come on. Now, somebody don't want to hear this. Because everything has been a watered down gospel. And God loves you. And you, God's going to make you a millionaire. And oh, God's going to bless your finances and this and that. But what's happening now? The stock market is falling. So he said, and then ye shall they shall deliver you up to be afflicted and shall kill you, and you shall be hated of all nations for my sake. Oh, my God. You mean to tell me that you're going to be hated of all men for my name's sake? Now, they're not preaching this. Nobody wants to hear this. This is what Jesus said. This is all in red now, y'all. This is what Jesus is saying about the end times. I didn't say it. I didn't write it. Jesus said this. He said, and then shall many be offended and shall betray one another and hate one another. Isn't that the way it is sometimes in the grocery store? You grabbing for the last roll of toilet paper and somebody gets it before you get it. I mean, people are getting wickeder and wickeder and wickeder. Ain't nobody trying to help nobody anymore, but God's people are supposed to show love to each other because love covers a multitude of sins. Look what else is going to happen. And many false prophets shall arise and deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound and the love of many shall wax cold. Oh, that's been going on for a while, but now it's getting ready to get worse. Don't be going to your neighbor's house asking them, did they have a cup of sugar? That ain't going to happen no more. I mean, they're going to be, everybody's going to be trying to get for themselves now, as you notice. And he that endure to the end, the same shall be saved. Hold on. Huh? Hold on. A change is coming. Amen. Hold on. Praise God. He that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. So we got to keep holding on, saints of God. We got to keep on doing all the right that we know. Keep loving one another. Don't turn against each other. Don't do like the world. Love. Love one another. Somebody asks you for your cloak, you give them your coat. Amen. Because why? This is how men will know that we are Christ's disciples. This is how they're going to know. By their fruits, you will know them. Amen. And so, but he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. And the gospel of, and this gospel, hold up. We just talked about you're going to be hated of all men for my sake. Wait a minute. And this gospel, oh, they ain't preaching that kind of gospel today. A man going to be lovers of themselves, according to Titus and Timothy 3. Huh? Men will be lovers of themselves. Wait a minute, but it says, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world and as a witness unto the nations, and then shall the end come. So wait a minute, everybody ain't preaching this. The men, you're going to be hated of all men. Every disciple, I was talking last weekend, every disciple of Jesus was killed. Murdered. I mean, just plain murdered. Except for John the Revelator. You research it, look it up. They were all murdered, killed. I think it was John that was boiled in oil and then exiled to the island of Patmos. And the book of Revelation is written by John the Revelator. He was the same disciple that Jesus loved. Amen. I want you to look at how his disciples, his handpicked, the ones that he loved, the ones that he chose, how they were treated. But the verse 14, it opens your eyes to one thing. It says, and this gospel shall be preached all over the world. So all of this that we're talking about today, this is what Jesus is talking about that needs to be preached before the end comes. And if it don't get preached, then he can't come back. But this gospel that Jesus is talking about, this ain't no watered down, you're going to get rich gospel that we're talking about today. This is about suffering. And people don't want to hear about suffering because
They figure, oh, Jesus suffered for one time. But if you put, you stick your neck out and start talking about Jesus, you see what I'm talking about. You see where I'm coming from. How he told Paul, he said, I want you to see what things you have to suffer for my name's sake. Didn't he tell Apostle Saul that when he got knocked down by the light? Huh? Somebody's not getting it this morning. But everybody wants to be, have everything and be blessed and all that. And we are blessed. Thank God I'm blessed. Praise God. God has given me a lot. But God wants us to reach down deeper. He's asking us this morning for our all. So what happens when they declare a declaration that everybody has to take the mark this morning? What's going to happen? How much do you love the Lord? Are you willing to stick your neck out and get it cut off for the name of Jesus? That's what it's coming down to. Somebody don't believe that this morning, but that's what it's coming to. So what do we need to do? We need to prepare our minds and don't be troubled and trust in Jesus. Because I'm telling you, it's coming down to that. We're getting very, very close to the end. These are just the beginning of sorrows, though. Don't get me wrong. This is just the beginning of sorrows where people are not able to go out in public after a certain time and they've set curfews. All of this is just the beginning of sorrow. And somebody said, oh, it's not going to last very long. All things are going to be back to normal. I'm here to tell you, no, it's not. That's a lie from the devil. That's a lie. It is not going to cease. This is just the beginning of it. We are getting ready, and where people may go back to work, everything may be fine, and then you'll hear about something else like this again. And it'll keep repeating itself. Until, as they say, the one world order comes into effect, which is already in effect, but it hasn't been completely implemented yet. And so we need to prepare ourselves, saints. We know in verse 21, I'm going to skip down a little bit. We know that many that are saying that they are of Christ and are not, we're talking about the Antichrist, the papacy. We know about that. In verse 15, it talks about, When you therefore shall see the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet stand in the holy place, whosoever readeth, let him understand. So it's talking about the Antichrist coming into the temple of God, proclaiming himself to be God. That's the abomination of desolation. And so it talks about let him that is on the housetop not come down or anything out of his house. So we know that there's a lot that's getting ready to happen. And we're just in the beginning stages of it. Then verse 21, I'm going to skip down a little bit. For then shall be great tribulation such as not since the beginning of the world to this time or never shall be. Except those days should be shortened, there shall be no flesh saved, but for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. So what are they doing? They are shortening our days. They've been shortening our days for many, many years, but now we can't go out. Our days are shortened in a different way. We got a curfew. We have to be inside. And so I thank God this morning for scripture and being in Bible prophecy. You know, sometimes it may seem like we're not following in Christ's path, but when we look at it, and look at it over time, I say, oh, God, I see why you told me to do that. Okay, God, I see what you were doing, what you were saying now. But like I said before, it's a wonderful thing to know Jesus. Praise God. It's a wonderful thing to know Jesus this morning. So we need to look unto Jesus, look unto him. These things are in the scripture. You can read them for yourself in Matthew chapter 24. They're there. Read what Jesus said that would happen. And the gospel ain't what most people think it's about. Most people think this is a sweet gospel. You know, he died and shed blood for our sins, and now we can just do whatever we want to. I'm here to tell you, it's a lie. And you can just repent over and over again. No. And God will forgive you and just keep on sinning, and it's going to be, no. That's not what, no. No, no, no. The gospel shall be preached. I'm going to decline you. The gospel shall be preached all over the world. and then shall the end come. And this gospel, the one where they talk about hating us for the name of Jesus, that gospel shall be preached all over the land. About wars and rumors of wars. All this must come to pass, people. All of this that we're going through right now, Jesus knew about it. All of it has to come to pass. And still, the end is not yet. But he said, when the gospel gets preached all over the world, this is why it's important for us to keep on preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because we want it to get all over the world, because we want him to come back. We want to keep preaching this gospel. Not the one where you're going to get rich quick and you just believe God for that car, honey. It's yours. I mean, no, that's not what I mean. God wants you to have things. God does. And we're not lacking for anything. I thank God for that. But that's not what the gospel is about. It's not about financial, stability. And even though Jesus himself had gold. By the kings that came and frankincense and myrrh, priceless. He had money. Jesus did when he was born. His mom and dad, Mary and Joseph. But and he even owned a house in Capernaum. Jesus did. But it's not about material things, people. It's because this stuff can be here today and gone tomorrow, as we well know. We've seen the tornadoes and hurricanes come through, and people. Everything they work for their entire life is gone. So we need to understand that Jesus is the only, he's the rock. He's the only thing that we have left in the world that we can hold on to. So we need to look to him with everything we have, with everything that we have, our family, hold tight to them, get somewhere, somebody get together and hold your family together, all your children, get them all together in one room. Put your arms around them and pray with them. Love on them. Because why? We don't know how much time we have left. Now, of course, his prophets don't even know when no one knoweth, not even the angels in heaven, when the end of time will come. Not even me. No one knows the day or the hour that the Son of Man is coming. According to Matthew chapter 24, it says that in verse 35 and 36 and 37, that no man knows the day or the hour that the Son of Man cometh. But as the days of Noah, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. For in the days, I'm reading in verse Matthew 24. I'm all over the place this morning because I'm trying to combine last week with this week. And it's, I'm sorry. But anyway, Matthew chapter 24, and I'm going in verse 37. We're back in Matthew chapter 24. But as the days of Noah were, so shall be also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as the days that were before the flood, where they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, and the day of Noah, they entered into the ark. And they knew not until the flood came and took them all away, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. Then shall two be in the field, and the one shall be taken and the other left. Two women shall be grinding at the mill. One shall be taken, the other left. Watch therefore, for ye know not the hour your Lord doth come. Watch, look. The word watch means look. And the title of the message today is Looking Unto Jesus. Watch for him. Come on, let's say I'm looking for him. I'm looking up now instead of looking around. I'm looking up because I know he's coming. Watch therefore, for ye know not what hour your Lord doth come. But know this, that if the good man of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Now there's the word suffer again, people. Wait a minute. And these are all the words of Jesus. Suffer. What is that about the word suffering? Well, Jesus is mentioning that word a lot. Therefore, be ye also ready, for in such an hour as ye think not, the Son of Man cometh. So when everything is looking like everything is fine, and I can do my thing, he's coming back. at that very hour, you think not. Amen. So we need to be ready. We need to be ready. Praise God. And you know, if you don't get anything out of this lesson today at all, because you see what I'm seeing already. I don't have to get up here and tell you what's happening in the news media. I'm sure you're looking at it every day. But God wants you to know today that you need to prepare yourself, prepare your mind. Don't get depressed and don't get sad. Don't feel like this is the end of the world yet, because the end is not yet. But God wants you to be ready. He wants you to look to Him. And while you're looking, get yourself ready. Get your mind mentally ready. Get sobered up, because why? You got to figure out who you're going to serve, whether it's going to be God or man. Huh? Whether it's going to be God or the devil. And so we, as children of God, at the last minute, at the last second, we may be persecuted. Matter of fact, it does talk about, and for then there will be a great tribulation as the world has never seen. So that's in verse 21. The great tribulation is coming, saints. It's coming to you, the saints of God. It's coming. Oh, gear up your minds, because it's coming. And it may not be the way you think it's going to be, but the great tribulation is coming. And it may come while we are here on the earth, and it may come while we are, well, it's going to come regardless. But for those of us that have made ourselves ready, we can go with Jesus. We might have, and you know, I'm not a before tribulation and I'm not an after tribulation. I'm just a waiting on Jesus, a Christian. I can't tell you the rapture is going to take place before the great tribulation. I don't want to get into an argument about that. I just want you to know that we need to be ready to suffer for the name of Jesus. We all need to be ready, because we're just about right now for this thing to be implemented, that they want to implement. The world is not going to stay like it is. It's not business as usual anymore. So we need to gear up our minds and realize today that we have a job to do, and that's continue to get the gospel out. If you can preach it, preach it. If you can witness about it, witness about it. But do your part to get the gospel out. Praise God. And help me. Help those that are laboring. Help those women that labor in the gospel. As Paul said, help those women. Amen. Labor in the gospel. So today, as we end the Bible study, because we're not going to continue to, but we want you to look to Jesus. This is the Sabbath day, and we thank God for our Sabbath. Like I said, I come to you every Sabbath day. I've been doing that for a while, online Bible ministry. And I have a website, BibleVisionMinistries.org. I will update it with this video for those of you that have not heard it or will not be listening to this all the way through. When you have spare time, do listen to it. I love you. I want you to know that. Jesus loves you. And if you need Jesus to be, you know, to be the Lord of your life today, if there's something in your heart or in your life that you know that's not right with God, if you know that you're not where you need to be in Christ this morning, praise God, this is the time. This is the acceptable time unto salvation. This is the real, you know, time to get your life right with God before everything goes down and you don't have nobody but yourself to, you know, because people are going to turn against each other in this time. If it ain't already happening, it's already happening. The people that you used to know that you could depend on, churches now, nobody's going to be there because the doors are getting ready to close the churches. This is almost the end of the church age. Somebody don't believe me out there. It's almost the end of the church age because our doors are being shut. Not the way we thought they would be shut. Some people say, I'm still going to church on Sunday. Okay, how long is it going to last? Because like I said, the Lord told me years ago to do the online ministry thing. Somebody said, that ain't scriptural. Somebody came against it and said, that's not scriptural. But I'm here to tell you, when God tell you to do something, you better do it. It may not make sense at the time, but you better obey God. Amen. Praise God. We're going to have prayer right now. For those of you that don't know the Lord, pardon of your sin, and this is the time to give God your life. So I want you to repeat after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you and we thank you, God. We ask that you forgive us of all our sins. God, we repent this morning for every sin, known and unknown, omitted and admitted. God, we ask you today to forgive us. Forgive the nation for our sins. We pray and we ask, God, that you come into our heart and fill us up with the Spirit of God, and that we might know what direction to take in our lives, God. We ask, God, that you touch the president's heart, and I thank you for touching his heart. Lord said, I've already done that. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. I feel the confirmation of that. Hallelujah. But there's more that needs to be done. And God, I ask you, God, as I talk, because there's the time is winding up and it's getting short. So God, I ask you to not only touch the president and the congressmen and just everyone under the sound of my voice, God, that they will get through this, and that we will prepare as saints of God for the second coming of Jesus Christ, because he's coming. And God, I thank you, God, that we're going to help each other. We're not going to turn against each other. We're going to be helped to one another. We're going to love on one another. We're going to be there for one another. God, we love you. We praise you. Praise God. And we thank you for answering our prayer this morning. God, help us to get through it. Give us every need. Make sure every need is met of each and every individual that's listening to me and the sound of my voice, and even those that are not. Heal the sick, God. Those that are sick, God, let them come to the foot of the cross, God. But we know that this is just because you want them to not miss you, not miss heaven. And so, God, those that are suffering, from being sick, God, let them repent of their sins and come to the foot of the cross, that you might, because you died, that we might have the right to the tree of life. So we have the right to go to heaven and have the right to love, and this world will be a better place. But God, we know that seducers will wax worse and worse, and that this is just the beginning of sorrows. So we ask you to help us to endure, because you said, he that endureth to the end shall be saved. So we thank you right now. We give you praise. We give you honor. We thank you for saving the lost. We thank you for healing the sick. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, that's all the time we have today. We want to thank you for tuning in to Bible Vision Ministries. And remember that the power of the kingdom of God is in you. Praise God. We thank you. Amen.